Welcome to Prague in the Czech Republic as Praha take on Valencia. This is game day 9 of the EuroLeague women regular season. Praha, truly one of those powerhouses of women's basketball, and they enter today's game on a 3-game winning streak. Valencia also have a little bit of form behind them as well, including starting 2023 with an impressive 2-point road win in Italy against Virtus Bologna. We are here for what should be a very, very interesting game today. Just about to have the players introduced here in the arena. And we will count down to our tip-off here in game day 9. This is group 8, remember. And what an interesting group this is stacking up to be. We have three teams sitting top of the table at the moment. Fenerbahce, Polkovica and Praha, all with a 6-win, 2-loss record. Valencia in fourth with a 5-3 record. And that is where we are set for today's game. As Valencia are our guests this evening here in Prague, they will be introduced to the crowd first. And this Valencia team certainly know how to push Praha close. They went down by just 7 points in the reverse of this fixture. That one was back on game day 2. And really, you have to say it's Vuka Savljevic that saved the day for Praha. 33 points out of the hands of Vuka Savljevic. Obviously, alongside that, the obligatory double-double from Alyssa Thomas was key to Praha walking away with the win on that night. But Valencia, as they're introduced here, they've looked good offensively this season. They play a nice style of team basketball. And when you combine that with very, very tough on-ball defense, that is why they picked up some big wins, including wins over Borges, Olympiakos, Zexard, and last week completing the double over Virtus Bologna. Valencia may enter the game as underdogs, but I certainly wouldn't put them as rank outsiders in this one. They are going to push Praha pretty hard today. The home team, once again, have been building towards that Final Four. They truly are an iconic club. They continue to build that reputation. As I said, they sit joint top of Group A with that 6-2 record. Those two losses just against the teams that also sit at the top of the table with them, Polkovica and Fenerbahce. And they are once again making their way to a run at the Final Fours. Only area of concern for Praha, and this is historic really, is that they run a short rotation. Potentially fatigue can play a part in the latter stages of the game, but we haven't really seen that be a problem so far this season. And that does come down to the players that they run in that short rotation. To every single one of them, they are warriors. They play with a certain mindset, the battle mindset. And that is why they can potentially run that short rotation. Expect Praha, though, to attack the basket, play some defense with some intensity. And you look at this game, and unusually, we've got two teams that want to play very similar styles of basketball. It will be a battle of who can play the better version of that basketball. Teams do air high fives on the center court. They enter their final preparations now, under 5 minutes to go before our tip off here. Players really do start to lock in on the game. They start to really zone in on what they need to do to come away with the win. Today for Valencia could be huge. It would put them on the same record as Praha. Both teams have moved to a 6-3 record for Praha. A win is important because they want to stay in the race alongside Polkovica and Fenerbahce to lead Group A. Remember, we are in the second half of the regular season now. It's downhill all the way to the Final Fours as the teams chase out for a top four spot in each group. Plenty of games going on around EuroLeague Women's today as well. Alongside our game here, tipping off a couple of hours ago, was Fenerbahce against Zexard. Fenerbahce coming away with a 20-point win, 91-71 on that one. Tipping off at the same time as our game here. Joint top, Polkovica taking on the winless Olympiakos. And then in 30 minutes' time, Lorne will take on Avenida. And then rounding out in an hour's time will be Borges against Virtus Bologna. Three games tomorrow on the board as well for EuroLeague Women. Sopron against Jukurova. That one is our game of the week. So make sure you tune back in for that tomorrow. and then Skio against Girona and Mechelen versus DVTK. Just moments away, under 3 minutes to go now to the opening tip here as the teams enter those final phases for Valencia. They'll be leaning once again, unbelievably, on their 21-year-old big, Raquel Carrera. She has looked pretty impressive this season. Leads the team in scoring with 12.4 points per game. Also dragging down just under 5 boards a game. And alongside her in that front court, Lauren Cox has been working hard getting the job done. The American is the only other Valencia player averaging double digits alongside 5.3 rebounds. As for Praha, well, plenty of the limelight once again this season falls on Alyssa Thomas. She builds an MVP level season. Tell me she's not in the shout for that award. Averaging a double-double in a usual warrior fashion. But alongside her, Brianna Jones continues to deliver her own double-double average. And the addition of Temi Fagbenli, the GB international, has made the Praha front court potentially one of the best in the competition. And when you slide that alongside Oblak and Conde in the backcourt, you can see why they have picked up 6 wins. You can see why they are favourites to make it through to the Final Four this season. Very, very close now to the start of the game. Both coaches will have had their final words. Coach Hezhkova has, as her 5 come to the floor. Coach Burgos, though, well, he knows his team are underdogs. He knows that maybe the pressure isn't on them, and the expectation that comes with that pressure isn't there, and that may be a little bit freeing for the players. You do feel, though, Valencia can stay into this game through to the fourth quarter. They've got a chance of sneaking an upset. As for Praha, that short rotation is really the only Achilles heel that they have. And if Valencia do stay in the game to the fourth quarter, that might be costly. We are yet to see on that one, though. Remember, these two met on game day 2. That was a 7-point win for Praha. Form books probably suggest that we'd expect a Praha win again here today, but I would not write Valencia off. Been a bit of a wild card this season, and they have got more than enough talent and quality in that roster and in the coaching team to force the upset here today. Valencia 5 come to the floor. Just a reminder before we have the opening tip, do get your phones out, download the official EuroLeague Women app, available on Android and iOS, completely free, a really indispensable companion to have alongside you whilst you watch the games and follow the season as it progresses. Underway here in Prague. Group A action, EuroLeague Women regular season, as table topping Praha take on Valencia. Early pace to the game is good. Conde pulls up. A little bit short with that attempt. Rebound by Oblak. She'll bring it back to the top and reset. Veteran guard once again, really doing a phenomenal job in the backcourt for Praha. Inside to Jones. Jones just bullies away to the basket. Draws the foul. That one's going to be on Cox. Lauren Cox with an early foul. And that's a smart play for me from Praha. Try and get some of the key players for Valencia in foul trouble. The likes of Cox and Carrera. If they can force that, then that's a big opportunity. Splits the free throws. Jones hitting the first and missing the second. Shooting 67% this season from the free throw line. Brianna Jones averaging just shy of 20 points. Strong drive to the basket, but the defense collapses well. Conde will scoop up the loose ball. 3-on-1 break. This is only going to end one way, and it's with Oblak getting the transition score. Both teams really pushing the pace early here. Casas nails the 3 from the wing. Shooting over 35% from distance this season. And a steal Casas, coast to coast, kicks it back out. Pereira has it knocked away by Thomas. Hands it off to Conde, off the window for two. My goodness me, this is free flowing. Both teams just playing really loose run and gun basketball. Expected them to go after it, but maybe not so freely with so much pace early on. Strong drive inside, but the finish isn't quite there. Casas, baseline drive, goes for a reverse layup. The defense is standing strong though from Brianna Jones. O'Black tries to feed it inside to Vukosavljevic, but that's a kick ball. Blistering near first 2 minutes of this first quarter. Praha hold a 2-point lead over Valencia. Pick and roll now. O'Black slides to the basket. A little heavy-handed, but Alyssa Thomas is just there to hustle down the board. And Alyssa Thomas just continues to impress. Game after game, week after week. Fifth season at Praha. Really has carved a name out for her in European basketball. One of the best. Casas at the top. Shaping up against Thomas. Kicks it out. Cox for the three. Too heavy, but the shot clock was expiring. Out in transition. Conde couldn't quite hold on to the pass. Lovely handle. Ball is knocked out of bounds by Valencia. That will be Praha ball on the baseline as Taya O'Black gives her teammates a round of applause. Drums ringing out around the arena. The mascot is all in. O'Black. Short little jumper. That one will drop. Second score of the game for Taya O'Black. Averaging just under 12 points a game. Season high of 28 against Zexar, but that was all the way back from game day one. Shot goes up, off target. Great defense by Vukosavljevic, but then handed it straight back with the Vigna steal. 6-point lead for Praha. They'll be happy keeping Valencia to that single bucket so far. First almost 3.5 minutes now. Conde waiting for the Jones screen at the top, maybe a little bit far away from the basket. That's smart play from Valencia, pushing the offense further away, but Jones with a quick little drop step along the baseline leaves Correa in a wake. Cox now on the outside against Jones. Interesting battle between these two today, Cox and Jones. Oh, what a beautiful post move. Lovely little step back from Lauren Cox. Real high efficiency shooter though, shooting 48% from the field. Jones is going to return the favour though, on that's just pure power from Brianna Jones. That is going to push Valencia into a timeout. Praha already 13 points on the board under 4 minutes played. Praha not going to take their foot off the gas. One of the top scoring teams in EuroLeague Women this season, averaging over 83 points a game. So coach Ruben Burgos to sort out. Let's see if we can check into his huddle. Blistering start to the game here in Prague. Pavlovka Arena. Providing a wonderful venue once again. A strong start to the game for Praha. Really spreading the scoring as well for different scorers across. across those 13 points. Breonna Jones leading all scorers with 5. Just behind her, Taya O'Black has 4 alongside 2 rebounds. Hat tip to Alyssa Thomas as well. She's already got 3 assists to her name, facilitating things so far. As for Valencia, only 2 players, only 2 field goals to be fair. Casas with the score, as is Gulic. How has Coach Burgos changed things up in that huddle? What will he see now that's different from his team? Strong move, Torrens, no good. Torrens having to work so hard to get to the bucket, and the shot just wasn't there in the end. You almost had a feeling that the energy levels have been a little bit depleted, how hard she'd had to work to get there. O'Black got the mismatch she wants, being guarded. Inside to Thomas, skip pass to O'Black, another pass to Jones, who's wide open but misses potentially the easiest opportunity of the night so far. Oh, out in transition, Cox, beautiful play. The big just kept running. Oh, and a steal, good quick hands, pulls up. Oh, drains it from the elbow, Torrens. And just like that, Valencia quickly hustle their way back into this one. Praha's lead trimmed to just 6 now. Lukas Savljevic will head to the bench. Rajkova will come in. Torrens asking for the foul. Having a conversation with the officials. The lead is trimmed to 4 on the make from Torrens. Conde now. Hesitation, good defense from Cox. Jones working hard, trying to grab her own board. She does, goes for the scoop, nothing there. Thomas with another offensive rebound, and it is just relentless on the offensive glass from Praha, and that is the problem. You almost feel like Valencia may need to drop into a zone defense just to clog the paint up, give themselves some numbers to defend their own board. Pass inside, that's a near impossible pass for the catch. Gulic. My apologies, I've been mistaking Lauren Cox for Gulic. Pass is stolen away. Conde now. Called, and Jones draws another foul. Third foul of quarter for Valencia. Breonna Jones will head to the bench. Into the game for the first time comes Great Britain international Timmy Fagbenley. Drive inside by Conde. Defense just collapse into the paint, though. How can Valencia counter this? Trail by 6. Gulic now. Looking at back. Fagbenley down. Foul's going to be called. Not sure who that foul was blown on. Praha plays such high-intensity on-ball defense. Foul on Gulic. Sorry, on Alyssa Thomas. Gulic drawing a foul. Gulic now drives a baseline. Tough move. Oh, looked like she may have overplayed it, but she gets the score. That is a great play by Marie Gulic. Thomas can only knock it out of bounds. Praha, well, they started very, very brightly in the last 2 or 3 minutes after that Valencia timeout. The Spanish side have really started to wrestle control away from the hosts. Vina back out to Gulic. Gulic for three. Nails the big shot. My goodness. Marie Gulic, 4 from 4 from the field. 9 points already. She's only averaging 9.5 points a game across the season. Featured in every single game, though. And another mistake from Paha this time. Conde just lets the ball slip through her fingers. And Coach Hezhkova's going to call a timeout. She needs to stop the rot. Valencia back within a single point. At one point, Praha held an 8-point lead. That has all but disappeared now. Let's see if we can head into this Praha huddle. Panic stations for Praha. They know they've got the experience and the talent to deal with it. If anything, just a little bit of a mental lapse in the last few plays. A couple of unforced turnovers. It's enabled Valencia to barge their way back into this game. Praha led by 8. Now that lead is just 1. Valencia now have to see how Praha change things up. I don't think they're going to change things up radically. I think it was just a little bit more of a reset button. Oh, nice drive to the basket. It's a great screen at the top, but wasn't capitalized on fully. Stolen back, though. Another mistake from Praha. Oh, on the trail. Doesn't get the finish. In fact, Benle with some good defense. It was enough to divert that one. Oblak wide open for 3. A little heavy. Lamana brings it down, brings it up. Gulic now. Salvadores misses the jumper from the mid-range. Both teams not looking great offensively. Transition, that's where you're going to get some easy points. This time Voracekova. Missed some of the early games this season, but really finding her feet yet again, the 23-year-old. 17 points against Olympiacos on game day 6. Casas now kicks it out. Correa nails the long 2. What a season. The 21-year-old's been having 12.4 points a game, 4.9 rebounds. 19 against Virtus Bologna last week in that 2-point win. Thomas almost has it stolen off her, stumbles to the basket, draws the foul. Have to earn a point from the free throw line. Many people chalk up shooting as one of the weaknesses for Alyssa Thomas. She has an unorthodox shooting style for sure, but she's shooting 67% from the free throw line. Makes both from the free throw line. She'll head to the bench as Brianna Jones comes back in her place. And that is the joy that Coach Hezhkova has. She really only runs a 6 or 7 player rotation on most nights. That's 6 or 7 players. The level doesn't drop a huge amount. She has some real talent to work with. Final minute now of this first quarter. Praha lead by just 3 points. We expect it to be pretty close. Valencia have shown some true character already. They trail by 8. And with that, the lead is down to just 1 now for Praha. Smart play by Casas. Benle head to the free throw line. Valencia are in the penalty. Is it just an out of bounds? No, it is a foul. Oh, that is them into the penalty though, so she won't head there right now. On the next one, if there is one in the next 28.1 seconds, she will. Pass inside, Fagbenlay, no good. Comes out, slow things down. Seven to play with. Rutschkova throws a tough pass and it's stolen away. 2-on-1 break now for Valencia. Oh, the recovery defense is good, but Valencia will grab the offensive rebound. They've got seven to work with. Gulich won't take that long. And she gets another score. What a night for Marie Gulich. 5 from 5 from the field in the first quarter. 12 points. And that is the first lead of the game for Valencia. What a way to close out the first quarter of action here in Praha. Gulich draining another big three ball. At the end of 10, it's Praha 19, Valencia 21. That lead has disappeared and it's now Valencia with a 2-point lead at the end of the first quarter. Leading all scorers, Marie Gulich. 5 from 5 from the field, including 2 triples. 12 points, 6 minutes 51 of action on the floor for her. Just behind her, supporting at Casas with 5 points, 2 rebounds, 3 assists and 2 steals. As for Praha, their leading scorer, Brianna Jones, she has 7 points and 2 rebounds. O'Black and Thomas both with 4 points apiece. Thomas working towards a triple-double though. 4 points, 4 rebounds, 5 assists and a steal. And she was only on the floor a little over 8.5 minutes in that first quarter. Gulich now will hand it off. Salvadores, a little hesitation, drives inside. Oh, that's a super smart play from the Spanish guard. One of those second string players, so vital to Valencia so far this season. At 13 against Zexard earlier on in the regular season. Thomas, free throw line jumper, no good. Teams this year have been punished by giving Alyssa Thomas that space. She didn't punish Valencia that time. 6-point lead now for the Spanish team on the road here in the Czech Republic. Gulich looking to go to work against Jones. Shot clock will run out on her though. Brianna Jones just playing real denial defense. Every which way Gulich pivoted and turned. She turned to face Brianna Jones and a hand in her face. Thomas now to Vukosavljevic. No, it's not. It's to Villalova on the wing. Jones, long two. Rattles it home, but I was about to say, Praha's offense static and stagnant. No real confidence in running through their set on that possession. But that jumper from Jones not only takes her out to 9 points, also reduces Valencia's lead to 4. Foul's going to be called, though. Chance for Romero to go to the line. 73% so far this season, Leticia Romero. Valencia really running through their roster as well, and this could pay big dividends towards the back end of the game. 11 players have seen action on the floor so far for Valencia. It's only 8 for Praha. Praha only have 10 suited up today. Valencia's lead back out to 5. Romero missing the first but hitting the second. Her first points of the game. Black, some urgency to Jones. Oh, spin move. What footwork from Brianna Jones. She can play the game with power. She can play a bit of bully ball. But she's also light on her feet. Very, very athletic. Deceptive at times, Brianna Jones. Villalova now. Elbow jumper. That one's nothing but the bottom of the bucket. Praha back within 1. Villalova's first points of the game. Good ball movement here by Valencia. Quick first step as well. Oh, what a move to the bucket. Smart play this time by Buonavida. Foul's going to be called on Buonavida, though. Gets in a little bit of a wrestling match with Vukosavljevic. Giving up almost 10 centimetres in that battle, though. Always going to be tough for her to defend Vukosavljevic in the post. Just over 3 minutes gone in this first quarter. In the second quarter. Valencia lead by 3. Everyone had this game as being close, but Praha to come away with the win. Valencia are having none of it so far. They've trailed by 8 and battled their way into the lead right now. Foul will be called. I think that one is on Buonavida again. Second team foul of the quarter for Valencia. Baseline ball again for Praha. Villalova has it batted away. Gulic playing hard on both ends of the floor today. Oh, and the pass is a thing of beauty. Easy 2 points for Alyssa Thomas. Plowing away to a triple-double right now. 6 points, 4 rebounds, 6 assists. Gulic, cross-court pass. Oh, lovely little step back. Oh, wow! Buonavida. Putting a school in session on that one. Absolute textbook play. All on the footwork. Vukosavljevic. That's just a poor pass from Thomas, to be honest. Vukosavljevic hadn't established herself, and the Thomas pass was a little bit too hot, a little bit too high. Buonavida again looks to go past Vukosavljevic. Foul's going to be called, though. That will send Buonavida to the free throw line, and she's taking control of this game right now, the 18-year-old. Heading to the line for 2, yet to miss a free throw in this year's competition. From 4 so far. Alyssa Thomas just having a conversation with the official. Still talking about the previous play where she thought that Vuka Savlevic got bodied out. That's why the pass was off target. Juanavida continues to be perfect from the free throw line this season. Connects with both. Takes her tally to 8 points now. She'll head to the bench. Back in comes Torrens. This is the strength of Valencia. This is the advantage they have. They'll rotate, they'll move. Players won't spend prolonged periods of time on the floor. Whereas for Praha, they will. Expect three or four players to play 30, 35 minutes in this one. Shot goes up from Villalova's no good. Vuka Savljevic just throws herself to the floor to secure possession. Jump ball will be called. Possession arrow in favour of Valencia. Valencia now with a 6 point lead. They don't look like they're going to give it up too easily. Almost halfway through this second quarter. Valencia outscoring Praha in both quarters so far. Torrens brings it back out against Vuka Savljevic, trying to shake, trying to create some space. That is a long way downtown. That's going to come up way short. Great defense by Valerian Vuka Savljevic. Another mistake. This time Oblak throwing a poor pass. Quick transition. Wide open for the three ball off right. Foul will be called on Vuka Savljevic for pushing Alba Torrens. Fighting for that offensive rebound. At the moment, Praha looking a little unsettled. They don't use their confident usual self as Conde comes back into the game. There's someone that will pick a team up by the scruff of the neck and get them to play. Maria Conde just comes with an attitude as a kind of teammate that you have to follow. There is no choice. I'm sure that's what Coach Hezhkova would like right now. Shot goes up from outside and it's off the glass. Absolutely everything is going the way of Valencia. Gulic with another big shot. 15 points for her. 6 from 6 from the field. Phenomenal. Thomas backs her way in, but a little soft hook shot wasn't soft enough. Game high 9 point lead for Valencia. Oh, and this time Lauren Cox with the fade. Gets it in the post and just fades away on the corner jumper. And a steal. More great defense from Valencia. A 4-on-1 break. And it will remain Valencia ball. The Spanish team are just having a riot right now. They lead by 9. 6 minutes gone here in the second quarter. They've outscored Praha 17-8 in this quarter. As we see Fagbenle come back into the game. Timeout's been called though by Coach Hezhkova. No real surprise. Team have really struggled in this quarter. And their confidence is starting to look a little bit fragile. Let's jump into Coach Hezhkova's huddle and hear what she has to say to her team. Testing phases of the season so far for Praha. Not sure they've been subjected too many times to this level of pressure. I don't think they would have expected to be trailing by 11. I don't think they would have expected to be held to 27 points after 16 minutes. Mascot doing their best to get the crowd into the game. The crowd certainly will play their part. Gulic now. it off to Torrens. Torrens will step back out and go again to Romero. Almost loses it, but the three ball will open up instead, and she rattles it in. It's just never ending right now for Valencia. A 14-point lead on the road against Praha. Dreams really do come true for Coach Burgos. Three ball goes up, off target. In fact, Benley fighting for it. But it's Valencia that come away with it. Foul's going to be called on Jones. She reaches in, tries to strip it away. Instead, fouls Torrens. And you can see how pumped she is for this game. She knows how to win. Two times EuroLeague Women Finals MVP back in 2011 and 2014. Six times EuroLeague Women's Champion, 2011, 2014, 2016, 2018, 2019, 2021. Been there, done that, Alba Torrens. Connects with both free throws, extending Valencia's lead further. Torrens now starting to get on the scoreboard as well. 4 points for her. Just one field goal, though. Expect more contribution as the game progresses. Pass inside. And an easy score for Alyssa Thomas. You really can't overcommit on her. I can understand defensively you don't want to be caught basket side of her and her to use her strength and power against you. But you either have to front or just stay true to the defense. You can't kind of hedge halfway. She will penalize you every time for it. Torrens throws the prayer. Off the glass, no good. Rejection. I think a shot clock violation will be called. Or is it Fagbenle stepping out? Let's see what they say. I think they said Fagbenle stepped out. No, they didn't. Shot clock violation is going to be given. So it will be baseline ball for Praha. They'll make a change as Romero goes to the bench. 6 points, three rebounds, two assists. Hell of a job from the 27-year-old. O'Black now trying to create some calm and some structure to this team that they've been lacking so far. Conde being harassed and chased off the glass, a little bit light with that one. You can see the angle just wasn't the usual quality from Maria Conde. Gulich now hands it off, baseline drive, good quick skip pass. Torrens to Cox for three. That one's short. Trajectory a little flat. Conde. Oh, and we have a wedgie. Shout out to the No Dunks team if they want to register that one. They feel free to collect that one. Maria Conde wedgie here. Turnover ball. Valencia will take possession. No, in fact, it's a jump ball, and that will be in favour of Praha. Thomas to inbound. Goes long to O'Black. That's off the leg of O'Black. That will be Valencia ball. And this has been this is a collector's item. Praha, 13 turnovers already in this game. Make that 14 with that one. That is a rarity to say the least. They're averaging only 15 turnovers a game. Even through the first half here. Cox drives inside, pulls up and nails the jumper. Lauren Cox has that mid-range game, has it on lockdown. 2 from 4 from the field for her, just her second field goal of the game. Thomas now skip pass to the corner. In fact, Benley misses the corner three. Oh, sorry, the long two it was. And Valencia's lead is at 16. As we have a minute left in this first half. Stolen away. Alyssa Thomas, 2-on-1 break. Hands it off to Jones. In and out. Take a second attempt from Brianna Jones and she'll draw the foul. She'll be disappointed she didn't get it first time. She'll be happy that she has the opportunity of the three-point play, though. At the moment, Praha really having to work hard just to stay in this game. They led by 8 in the first quarter. They now trail by 14. As Brianna Jones comes up short with the free throw. Torrens moves the ball. That's a tough looking shot. Never one you're really going to have a high percentage on. From Uvina. Conde, short two is good. Maria Conde is the kind of player that just doubles down, tries to give you everything she's got. Timeout's going to be called by Coach Burgos. Just wants to snuff out any form of resurgence from Praha before the end of this first half. Less than a minute to play. Coach Burgos will want to lock it down, make sure his team enter the locker room with at least a 10-point lead. Let's see if we can jump into the huddles, hear what the coaches have to say. Back to the floor first, and understandably so. They really do want to make the most of the last few seconds in this quarter. They want some positivity to take to the locker room. Valencia just want to hold out now. They've done a great job in this first half. 27 seconds left in the first half. Sorry, 20 seconds left now. 12-point lead for Valencia. Uvina to Torrens. Has to pick it up off her shoelaces. Shot clock down to 8. Alyssa Thomas out in the break. Good defense in the end by Valencia. Unbelievably good defense, really. Very unorthodox. As Christina Uvina had a back to the offense when she was playing defense, but still manages to interrupt it. Can Praha get anything in this point? 2 seconds left on the first half clock. And that one will be waved away. And what a first half we've had here in the Kravlovka Arena in the Czech Republic in Prague. Praha flying high this season, but being grounded by Valencia in the first half. At the half, it's Praha 33, Valencia 45. What a first half of action we have had here in Prague.
Thank you.
5. Remember, Praha currently joined top of the table as things stand. As for Valencia, they're in fourth spot. However, just one game between them. Praha on a 6-2 record. Valencia on a 5-3 record. If Valencia can come away with the win, that will bring them both to the same record. And Group A is shaping up to be absolutely phenomenal this season. At the half, though, some heroes to shout out, particularly for Valencia. Marie Gulic, 15 points. And it's not just 15 points, it's 6-6 from the field for Marie Gulic. 3-3 from downtown, as well as 2 rebounds and a block to her name. Only other players registering more than a single field goal is Romero. She has 6 points and Casas has 5 points. As for Praha, Brianna Jones, their only player in double digits, 13 points, 6-10 from the field alongside 3 rebounds. And as you would expect, Alyssa Thomas building a nice little stat line. She's played a little over 18 and a half minutes. She has 8 points, 4 rebounds and 6 assists on her way to a triple-double. But more importantly for all of these players is the win that's at stake. A little over a minute to go to the start of the second half. These teams fighting hard to come away with the win. Remember, Praha entered the game on a 3-game win streak. Valencia on a 2-game win streak. Praha certainly favourites going into today's game. No two ways about that. The form book has been torn up a little in the first half by Valencia here in the Kravlovka Arena. Can they get the job done, though, or will Praha come away with the win? Remember, Praha also had an 8-point lead in that first quarter. What a swing we have seen. Valencia outscoring Praha in both quarters, but outscoring them 24-14 in that second. Both fives now back to the floor, ready to go for the second half of action. Valencia will have possession to start the second half and they want to start brightly. They don't want to let Praha get out and close this gap early in the quarter. Ready, getting the clock set, and then we'll be good to go here in Prague for the second half. And Fenerbahce picked up a win earlier today against Zegzard on their home floor. They won that one by 20. Also going on at the moment, Polkovica lead Olympiakos by 13. That one's a couple of minutes into the second half already. Also underway is Lorient against Avenida. About 3 minutes into the second quarter of that one, and Avenida hold a 6-point lead. Just some technical issues right now with the clock that they need to resolve, so both teams have been called back to their benches. Or have they? The officials work hard to try and resolve the issue. I think they have done. Coach Burgos wants to get underway, get things going. Players back to the floor. Interesting to see how this slight delay to the second half plays out, whether it suits Praha or Valencia more. You'd feel potentially Praha. Going to be a prolonged break as both teams will now go back into warm up for the second half. Both teams walking into their layup lines, making sure they keep loose and ready to go. Certainly not what Coach Burgos would have wanted. His team did a great job in the first half. They certainly played like a team with no pressure, no expectations. help them a great deal. They trailed by 8 in that first quarter. It looked like Praha were just going to storm their way to a win. 4 minutes gone in that first quarter and they already trailed 13-5, but they just didn't give up. And by the end of the first quarter, they actually led it. And Marie Gulich 3 right at the end of the first quarter gave them the lead. And then, although Praha fought their way back to within 1 in that second quarter, once again, Valencia just stepped away. Went great at scoring as well. And that's why they hold a 12-point lead with 20 minutes left on the game clock. Those of you joining us expecting the second half to be underway, we just have a couple of technical issues in the arena that need resolving, so the players have gone back onto the floor for second warm-ups. It looks like we're ready to go, though. All the tech is working. The Gremlins are out of the system, and it looks like we are ready to go. The Valencia 5 on the floor. Coach Burgos wants a final word before they come to. Officials are trying to get the game underway, but players just want to get their brains tuned back into the game. Second half action underway here in Prague. Game day 9. Halfway through this one, and it's the visitors, Valencia, who hold a 12-point lead over Praha. A wonderful first half of action. Will the second half live up to that level? Correa misses the first of her shots this half. Been slightly quiet in the game so far. Raquel Correa, just 2 points to her name. Remember, averaging over 12 a game. Conde now waits for the Thomas screen. Jones looks to step through. Correa bats it back, though it's stolen by Oblak to Thomas. Thomas just bullies away to the basket, doesn't get the score, and the tap back is no good. Valencia with the defensive rebound this time. Vina brings it up to the wing. Oh, and the three ball rattles home. That is exactly how Coach Burgos would have wanted his team to get the second half underway. What a start. And an easy score in the end for Breonna Jones. Clearly Praha trying to raise the physicality of this game. Look to use some of that strength and size advantage that they have in certain positions. Drive to the basket. Foul's going to be called on Oblak. Ovina picking up the foul off Oblak. Baseline ball for Valencia. First foul of the second half. Vina now looking for options. Uses the screen set by Cox, but gives it up. 2-on-1 break now. Thomas will go all the way. And misses the shot. Foul's going to be called on Lauren Cox. That will send Alyssa Thomas to the line for 2 shots. For me, that's a smart foul. Thomas is a good free throw shooter, but she's certainly not automatic from the free throw line. So Thomas a little bit quiet tonight, just 8 points so far. That said, she is on her way to a triple-double, so I don't know how quiet that is. She's now at 9 points, 4 rebounds and 6 assists with that made free throw. And hits the second as well. Casas can use the screen at the top from Cox. It's got the mismatch she wanted, but she'll pass away to Correa. Cox inside. Look to just ease Conde away from the basket a little. Officials say all's fair. Nice spin move by Thomas. Pass inside is way off track by Alyssa Thomas, though. Backdoor cut. Vuka Savljevic. Valencia having a scramble, hard to stay with this one. Foul's going to be called. That one on Vina. Valencia being made to work really hard on the defensive end. Already given up two of their team fouls, and we're only a little over 2 minutes into the second half. Thomas, easy score. Teo Black doing all the hard work. Drives to the basket. Thomas just seals out and creates that space. Valencia now back within 11. Casas inside, running left hand. No good. Rebound by Conde. Her second board of the game. Tries to spark the transition. Oblak, elbow jumper. Too heavy for Taya Oblak. And an easy score at the other end of the floor for Lauren Cox. And this is how Valencia have got this lead. They've just stayed with the game, up or down. They haven't changed the way they've played. Inside to Jones, and an easy 2 points for Brianna Jones. She's leading all scorers now. 17 points for the American big. Carreira hands it back now to Vigna. Shot clock to 9. Cox, looks like she pulled at that a little. Overstretching herself somewhat on that three ball. Has shot the ball well from outside this season though. 46% before today's game, Lauren Cox. 0 from 3 so far today though, so not going her way. Drums continue to ring out around the arena. They're doing their best to get their team back into things. Vuka Sabljevic is short. Cox trying to back her way down. Double team comes in. She fades away, and that's almost a signature jumper for Lauren Cox. She's executed it numerous times in today's game. She does it so many times, pretty much every game. Got it down to a T. Maria Conde a little flat with her jumper. The defense was tough, though. Stayed with her. She really didn't have any space to get that one away. 13-point lead for Valencia. We're almost halfway through this third quarter. They'll be happy that they still have a double-digit lead. It's pretty much they've done the job to create their lead. Casas had to take the shot as the shot clock was expiring. But for Valencia, they've got the lead. It's just a matter of maintaining it now. Foul's going to be called on Kalar Casas. A veteran wing just caught reaching in. Sideline ball for Praha. And it's down to Praha really to make a change, to do something differently in this game. Jones at the elbow. Poor pass and stolen away. Torrens goes all the way. What's the call? I think the foul's on Brianna Jones. Torrens working hard and overcommitting to drawing that foul. Brianna Jones saying, look, I'm standing, I'm retreating, my hands are up, what more can I do? Only the replay would show that. The official saying the foul is still there. Plenty of smiles though all round, even if they are slightly frustrated from Brianna Jones. Alba Torrens will head to the free throw line. Only 54% from the free throw line prior to today's game though, Torrens. Certainly has had a tough season from the line so far. 2 from 2 so far today though. Three from three. And the big players step up in the big games, and that's exactly what Alba Torrens is. Up to 9 points alongside 3 rebounds and 2 assists for the veteran Spaniard. Oblak now using the Jones screen. Skip pass to Vuka Sabljevic. Nice pass inside. Oh, that is smart play from Vuka Sabljevic. Just bullets the pass into Brianna Jones, who gets another 2. Up to 19 points now, Brianna Jones, and they've stolen it away. This time, Conde leading the charge. Oblak pulls up, long 2. That's good. realistically, if Praha get another score, there'll be a timeout called by Coach Burgos. He doesn't want to see his team's lead be pulled down into single digits. Torrens now going up against Vuka Savljevic. Draws some contact, steps back. Too heavy though. Can Praha break it down into single digits? This would be a big statement from them. Oblak back out to Jones. Pick and roll with Vuka Savljevic. Inside to Jones. She's got the space she wanted, but the defense just collapsed on her. That is great help defense from Cox. Vina now. Back to Carreira. Torrens. Skips it to the corner, almost stolen away by Alyssa Thomas. She cheats on the defense, reads the passing lane, and almost does enough to steal it away. Lauren Cox will come out of the game. Marie Gulich will come back in. And what a game Marie Gulich has had so far. Lamana also comes in for Ovinia. Gulich 15 points. Perfect 6 from the 6 from the field. Torrens hits the 3 on the wing. And this is what I'm talking about. Valencia, they're not going with the ebbs and flow of the game. They don't get too high when they're leading by loads. They don't get low when Praha start to play some good basketball. They just keep playing basketball. And that's what's given them this 14-point lead. Conde, 3 at the top. Oh, big play by the big player that is Maria Conde. She steps up time and time again for Praha. When the team need her, she steps in. Tries to drag the team with her. Stolen away. Thomas passes it out to Conde, who's leaked out. She'll get the easy 2, and timeout will be called by Coach Burgos as Praha have trimmed Valencia's lead to just 9. 2:51 left in the third quarter, and it's the Czech Republic team in the ascendancy right now that's forced the Spanish coach into the timeout. Let's see if we can jump into the huddles, hear what the coaches have to say. Praha continue to push. They've done a great job so far here in the third quarter. After a tough start to the quarter, they've now outscored Valencia 17-14. 17 points has come in a little over 7 minutes, which, based on today's pace, is a good lick for Praha. They'll need to keep it going, though. How did Valencia react? What has Coach Burgos done? When he called a timeout in the first half, he had the desired reaction, but they've thrown it away. Conde to Thomas. Good call by the official. Thomas just skipping into that spin move. Valencia will get to go again. They want to re-establish a double-digit lead as soon as they can. Keeping Praha here is not where they want to be. Torrens, ice cold from the top. 15 points now, 4 from 9 from the field for Alba Torrens. Conde back to Oblak. Conde receiving the treatment from Valencia, and it's paid off as they've stolen it away. Torrens, little hesitation, and steps through. My goodness. This is the Alba Torrens show right now. Lucas Savljevic on the wing. Foul's going to be called on Torrens. Valencia in the penalty. Savuka Savljevic will head to the free throw line. One of the best free throw shooters in the competition as well. 93% prior to today's game. French international has really had a big season. None more so than the reverse of this fixture. She had 33 points against Valencia earlier in the year. She's certainly not on track for that tonight, as that first free throw was her first point of the game. Tell me that they haven't studied game tape in Valencia on how to stop her. Oh, wonderful move. Casas just goes to the reverse layup. Elaine just opened for her, and she made Praha pay. 15-point lead now for Valencia. Thomas inside to Jones. Jones, a couple of drop steps, but nothing there. Conde, shot clock to six. Little floating right hand is good. Maria Conde has come out in a big way here in the third quarter. 11 points now for Conde, alongside three rebounds and three assists. Spanish international really trying to lead her team. Thomas with the rebound. Inside, Vuka Savljevic is locked up by Lamana. Send Vuka Savljevic back to the free throw line. In fact, she will sub out after this pair of free throws as well. What a rapid third quarter we've had here in Prague. 13-point lead at the moment for Valencia. Every time you feel that Praha have fought their way back into this one, Valencia just double down. You just stay with the game. They don't let the emotions or the state of play affect how they've played. Vuka Savljevic hits both free throws and she'll head to the bench on that one. Yet to make a field goal though. Valerian Vuka Savljevic, averaging over 19 points a game, and she currently has three. That tells you all you need to know. Temi Fagbenli is into the game for Vuka Savljevic for Praha. Oh, that is just tough basketball from Alba Torrens. She is taking her team on her shoulders right now. 21 points for Alba Torrens. She just knows how to win stuff. A champion in Spain, Turkey, Russia. Oh, she'd love to add another EuroLeague women's title to it as the clock for the third quarter expires. And another big, big quarter from Valencia. They have won every single quarter. Close one this time though, the third quarter, 22-23 in favour of Valencia. With 10 minutes left on the clock. Slightly and Olympiakos Polkovitsa leading that one 59-33. It's at the half in Lund and it's 29-44 in favour of Avenida. As for Bourges, they trail by 2 points with a little under a minute left in the first quarter. That's a roundup of our games here tonight. Tomorrow, three more games slated up, including the game of the week, a Sopron take on Cukurova. That one should be a really, really good game. Also on tonight, tomorrow night, Skio taking on Girona and Mechelen taking on DVTK. This season's EuroLeague women has been certainly one of the best in recent years. So competitive. No team unbeaten. Every team with at least two losses to their name. Only one team without a win, and that's Olympiacos. They continue to struggle tonight, but what a season we are having here so far. We could have another surprise on our hands here in Prague. 10 minutes away from a road win. An unexpected road win for many. A Valencia lead by 13 against Praha. Can they hold on? Fourth quarter underway here in Prague in the Czech Republic. Game day 9 in Group A, EuroLeague Women. And it's our visitors, Valencia, that leads 68-55 over Praha. 10 minutes left on the clock. Conde now looking to shake, create some space. Brianna Jones, long two. Slightly flat, rebound for Cox. And Valencia will go again. Romero slowing things down, and you expect Valencia maybe to slow the pace of the game down a little as Romero just dribbles it off a foot and out of bounds. 14th turnover of the game for Valencia. Praha, 18 turnovers so far in this game. That certainly has been an issue for them, as Valencia have scored 27 points off those turnovers, but Fagbenli comes in. Drains the long jumper. Torrens now skips it inside. Baseline cut by Gulic. Off the glass. Good defense by Praha, really. Just getting bodies in the way to interrupt the baseline cut from Gulic. Fagbenli now goes inside. Comes back out, though. Into the low post. Stolen away but fouled. This is the start to the final quarter that Praha will have wanted. Early mistakes from Valencia. A bit more tenacity on the offensive end. A little bit more physicality as well. That's how they got out to an early 8-point lead in this game. They were very, very physical. Looked to go inside. Looked to try and bully their way to points. Catch and shoot, Conde, a little heavy into the right. Oh, that was going to be a bullet pass, but Conde read it. 3-on-2 break, hands it off. Jones with the score. And just like that, Praha are within 9. Valencia need to jumpstart their offense right now. A few less risks, a little bit more high percentage basketball needed. Drive inside, draws the foul off Oblak, and pretty smart play, to be honest. I wasn't sure it was when I was watching it in real time, but thinking about it now, draw some fouls, get yourself to the free throw line, and just keep the scoreboard ticking over. If you're realistic, if Valencia can get to the early 80s, maybe another 12 to 15 more points. That will probably seal this game for them. That's the race for them. If they can get to 80, they'll probably come away with the win. Romero misses the first of her two, though. Hits the second. 10-point ball game, under 8 minutes to play. Romero up to 7 points. Valencia up to 69. Valencia now dropping into a 2-3 zone. Fagbenli with the long jumper. A little bit taken by surprise there, I think, with Valencia dropping into a zone for the first time tonight. Torrens now at the top, takes it back. Inside to Gulic. Kick to the corner, wide open but doesn't take it. Gulic will take the short two instead and gets the score. And that is super smart play by Valencia. Yes, they were open for the three ball. They had the belief that they could get a higher percentage scoring opportunity, and they did. Conde now, calling for the screen. It's a poor pass by Maria Conde. She was expecting Jones to come high for it, but Jones didn't want it there. Onto the wing. Valencia will slow it down. Pass is a little bit risky as Buonavida steps out of bounds just to hold on to that pass. Valencia need to slow things down a little bit now. The clock is on their side as we see Jones head to the bench and Villalova come back in. Interesting change by Coach Hezhkova. I imagine Jones will only be on the bench for a few moments unless the plan is to try and free things up a little bit, create a bit more perimeter shooting as we see Albert Torrens head to the bench. But Valencia now have just dropped straight back into a man defense, a matchup defense. Given up on their zone now that Jones has gone to the bench. O'Black calling for the screen. Fag Bentley's kind of caught between two stools there. O'Black called for the screen and then threw her the pass. I'm not sure that's the best play by her. But Valencia will steal it away. And there's the pass inside. Foul's going to be called on Thomas. Against Gulich. Mary Gulich has had an amazing game so far. 7 from 8 from the field, 17 points, a plus minus of 21. Great play by the German. Salvadores, spin move, baseline. Villalova just buys it a little bit too heavy. O'Black comes across and helps well. And the foul will be called. Second team foul on Valencia of the quarter. Mr. Thomas not happy. Ask him for the sub. She's been on the floor over 32 minutes. She's pretty much played the entire game. And this is the problem. I talked about it in the pre-game that Praha have. They're only running an 8-player rotation. And realistically, Borichkova's only played under 7 minutes. They're running a 7-player, well, 6-player rotation as Villalova's only played 8 minutes. It really is a 6-player rotation. And then you compare that with Valencia and they have 8 players in double-digit minutes. And that will pay dividends now. The official's going to go to the screen. I don't think Thomas was asking for the tub. I think she was asking for an unsportsmanlike foul, but using the wrong hand signal. Maybe she was asking for the sub, though. She's blowing pretty hard in that huddle. Burgos taking the time to speak to his team while the officials run through the replay. Good crowd here being entertained by what has been a very, very good game. They won't be overly happy that their team trailed by 12. They'll have come here expecting the win, as most Prague fans do. Plenty of smiles, though. Their team look pretty relaxed. In fact, the fans look a little bit more nervous than the team do. We have some visiting fans, though. There's the Valencia Hardcore, the Gulich fan club. Established this year by the looks of it. I'm sure they're recruiting members. If you head online, you'll be able to sign up to the Marie Gulich fan club. Not sure what kind of cool stuff you'll get from them, but worth a look. Plenty of young fans in the stands as well. Always good to see, inspiring the next generation to take up the world's best sport, basketball. And by no way am I biased in any way, shape or form. Who knows, we may see some of these faces don the jerseys on our TV screens in future years. Regular foul is going to be called, as the officials now say. It was just a straightforward foul. I didn't think it was going to be upgraded slightly from behind, but wasn't really stopping a transition. There they are again, their moment of fame. That road trip all the way from Valencia to Prague paying off. A little over 6 minutes to play, though, as we get back to the action. And Valencia lead by 12. Conde to Thomas. Smooth. Smart. Oh, that's a big play by Praha. Pagbenli finishes it off, but it wasn't all her hard work. That was an absolute team basket, and this is what Praha have been lacking in today's game. They haven't necessarily been playing that team style of basketball. I think they've been feeling they can do it on a one-on-one basis, and they haven't been able to. McBenley gets the three-point play converted, her fifth point of the game. Onside three rebounds, Temi Fagbenley. averaging a little over 10 points in the four games she's played up to today. Romero misses the jumper, but Valencia grab the gold dust that is an offensive rebound at this point of the game. Gulic now looking to go to work in the low post. Drop steps past Fagbenli. Fagbenli can't do anything to stop that. Marie Gulic just having the game of her life right now. 19 points for Gulic. That's her season high. Previous season high was against Praha back in game day two, where she had 18. And Praha will spill the ball out of bounds. And Valencia will take possession back. A little bit of time management is going to come into the game now for Valencia. They'll want to run the clock as best they can. They are on this possession. Shot clock down to seven. That is a tough play. Just for the hard-nosed nature of that one, you thought it was going to fall. Fagbenle has to come back out to the top. They've got plenty of time on the shot clock, though. That's the bonus of running a little bit hard in transition. Oblak now being guarded by Buonavida. Black has it blocked. Great defense there by Gulic. To the wing. Pass inside. Shot clock to four. Fade away. Marie Gulic doesn't get the roll this time. Rebound for Villalova. She puts a transition in. Has to slow it down, though. And Valencia now clearly running some clock. Villalova, corner jumper is good. Praha back to within nine. 4 minutes to play on the game clock. This one is setting up nicely to run all the way to the wire. Stolen away! Great defense and a great read by Villalova. Back-to-back buckets for Teresa Villalova. Coming in and getting the job done. Off the bench, played a little over 10 minutes and has made a huge impact at the business end of this game. Valencia not happy. They thought it was a foul. That's forced coach Burgos into a timeout. His team's lead is down to seven. We're going to head into some huddles and hear if we can find out what the coaches want to change. Big few minutes of basketball for both of these teams now. Nothing is signed, sealed and delivered this season. In Group A, really all the way down to seventh spot, is in the fight for one of the top four spots. Every single game is huge right now at this stage of the season. Valencia lead by seven. Ovinia misses the three. Thomas with the rebound. That's her double-double, 12 points, 10 rebounds. Sorry, it's not. That's 8 rebounds. She's got 9 assists. She's close to a triple-double. Alyssa Thomas, Villalova, continuing where she left off before the timeout, draws the foul and will head to the free throw line. Just a clarification. Alyssa Thomas, very close to a triple-double. 12 points, 9 assists, 8 rebounds. 3.5 minutes to play. Think she could care less as long as her team get the win right now. Villalova hits the first of her two. 100% from the free throw line prior to today's game. Villalova, she hasn't been there many times to Czech international, but when she's needed, she has stepped up in a really big way for for Praha. 9 points now for Teresa Villalova. She's averaging just 6 a game. It's featured in every single game this season in EuroLeague Women. 5-point lead now for Valencia. For me, 80 is still the magic number. If they can get to 80 points, I think they'll come away with the win. Stolen away, Alyssa Thomas now out of the races against Carrera. She misses. What great defense from the youngster, 21 years of age, going up against one of the best players in the world, and the defense is absolutely on point. Gulich, oh, what a time to hit a three. Marie Gulich is back at it again. She's gone quiet in the second half, and when she's needed, she has stepped up. 22 points now for Marie Gulich. Vukosavljevic to Thomas. Draws the foul and one play. Alyssa Thomas may have missed last time. She doesn't miss this time though. Carrera called for the foul. Thomas to the line for the bonus. Really needs to hit this. A 6-point lead for Valencia at the moment. Carrera's second foul. And hits the bonus, converts the 3-point play. Vigna takes the ball back. Foul's going to be called. That will be the fourth team foul of the quarter on Praha. Both teams in the penalty now. For now, though, Valencia will have a sideline possession. 2.5 minutes left on this one, and it is perched precariously on that tightrope. As both these teams look to battle it out for a huge win. Carrera, oh, beautiful footwork. Wow. That is some old school back to the basket pivot work from Carrera. My goodness me, bodies absolutely everywhere as O'Black looks to put everything on the line to get the score. Casas now picks up a dribble, hands it away to Torrens. Pull up for the long two. Off right. Vukosavljevic picks up, almost travels though, needs to be careful. Alyssa Thomas one on one. Leans in for the score, can't get it. Valencia pull it down. What a chaotic end to this game we've got. Both teams starting to look fatigued, both teams putting everything they can into it. Fatigue for Praha may now start to pay off. Alyssa Thomas has played almost 37 minutes in this game. O'Black almost 35 minutes in this game. No player for Valencia has played over 28. And that is your difference right now between these two teams. Timeout has been called by Coach Heshkova. She can feel the game slipping away. 1:43 left on the clock. Team trail by 5. The Praha faithful will believe all the way to the final buzzer, that's for sure. But this could be a big upset win for Valencia on the road, and really even more so throw Group A wide open. Fenerbahce with their win tonight will be top alongside Polkovica by the looks of it. As it stands, Polkovica with a 24-point lead over Olympiakos. Yes, they have won that one, in fact, by 24. So Fenerbahce and Polkovica will move to a 7-win, 2-loss record. If Valencia hold on to this, that will move Praha to 6 wins and 3 losses, and Valencia to 6 wins and 3 losses. And then with the Bourges versus Bologna game, will also have an impact on how the rest of the group shapes out. But Group A shaping up to be an absolute dynamite run into the postseason. Raquel Carrera at the line. Unreal when you think about it. 21 years of age. I know what I was like when I was 21. I certainly wasn't at a level of maturity that I could play in big games, contribute towards a huge win in European competition. Brianna Jones hands it off to O'Black. Inside to Thomas. It's stripped away though. That could be a big play. Praha trying to hustle. They don't want to foul, but they do want to steal. Valencia will happily slow it down and run some clock. Carrera looking to hand it back to Mavinha. She does in the end. Shot clock down to 7. Uses the pick at the top inside to Carrera. Draws the foul. She'll head to the line for free throws. 79% from the free throw prior to today's game. Raquel Carrera. 1 from 2 so far in today's game. That trip to the free throw line in the previous possession was her first of the night. Now her second. And she's short. The pressure starting to maybe play its part in proceedings here. Can she make the second? The crowd are going to try their best to put her off, that's for sure. She hits 1 from 2 again. 7-point lead, under a minute to play. This would be Herculean from Praha if they can come away with the win. Vukosavljevic inside, doesn't get it. Thomas with the rebound and the score. Alyssa Thomas with the triple-double. 17 points, 10 rebounds and 10 assists. Unbelievable from her. Valencia, though, look like they're close to the win here. Our pass inside to a wide open Raquel Carrera. And Valencia's lead is back up to 7. Praha now under a huge amount of pressure. Oblak to the corner. Foul's going to be called. It's an offensive foul on Alyssa Thomas. A moving screen. That surely is the nail in the coffin to close this game out. Valencia will take possession. Our Praha going to just foul straight away? Just send them to the line, or will they try and steal? Realistically, I don't think they can afford to foul. They just have to play real intense on-ball defense and look for the steal. Not even doing that, though, to be honest. Maybe they're thinking about the head-to-head. That's going to play its part as well. Remember, Praha won the return of this fixture by 7. That could play its part in who finishes higher. In and out, Vukosavljevic, 5 seconds. Valencia going to take the win, but will they take the head-to-head? Oblak launches the 3 and it's no good. What a game we've had here. Look at the celebrations from Valencia. Rightfully so. They have put in a hell of a performance on the road. They are coming away with the upset win. Final score here in Prague is Praha 75, Valencia 82. What a game. The road team come away with the win. A huge win as well. Praha have been looking good this season. They entered the game on a 3-game win streak, but Valencia were having none of it. Valencia started slowly. Praha opened an 8-point lead in that first quarter, but then really it was all one-way traffic as Valencia come away with a huge 7-point win. They led by 16 at one stage, but in the end, they come away with that 7-point win. The final score here in Prague is Praha 75, Valencia 82.